because of the nature of graduate school, you're in an environment with so many experts who have been doing research longer than you've been alive at that age. So it's very daunting. It can be very overwhelming.
Many students and professors will have heard of something described as the imposter syndrome. Many of us prefer to refer to it as the imposter phenomenon because it's not a problem with the student. It is an experience they have that is typically reinforced by the surrounding environment. It's the most capable, the ones who are striving for the most, who most typically feel like imposters.
When you look at your peers, you might have the perception that you are just among the cream of the crop and the best of the best, and how do I fit into all of this?
Everybody else seems to know how this works, and it can intensify these feelings that I don't belong. What we see on their outside is their best face, and what we tend to compare that to is what we feel about ourselves on the inside.
My experience of being one of few many times in different spaces conflicted with the capability, with the enthusiasm, with the awesome potential of the people that looked like me that I knew was available. So it just, it begged the question of why aren't there more people like me? If you're not aware of the barriers that are, that exist, that influence the representation at the graduate level and even on after that, you might start to fill in the blanks by saying, well, maybe there is a reason. Maybe we aren't as capable. Maybe there is something that's a deficiency that I'm not aware of.
That can really impact your sense of belonging and really question whether you belong in a particular situation. It can perpetuate a sense of being an imposter really impact your sense of identity as a scientist or as a scholar.
Once I started applying to graduate school, I went to San Jose State, which is a public school here in the Bay Area. I started getting invited to interviews and was feeling very self-conscious of like, oh, I'm coming from this school that no one knows about, and other people are coming from these, you know, Ivy League schools or Ivy League-like schools. One of my faculty mentors at San Jose State was just like, before I went on interviews, was like, you're good, you've got this, be confident, they'll be lucky to have you. And so I went on these interviews and there was, right, that little pep talk, I just like kept it in my head. And that for me helped relieve a lot of that like imposter syndrome feeling.
A lot of students hesitate to ask for explanations or help because they think it might reveal a lack of knowledge that they're expected to have. That is, it might reflect the fact that they don't actually belong in that space.
I've seen that, especially with students from underrepresented groups. If I feel that my being present in a program or in a department or in any kind of space is a representation of an entire group of people. My willingness to admit that I don't know or my willingness to seek help may be a bigger hurdle because I just don't want to give the wrong impression or I don't want to confirm someone's negative stereotype that they might already have about me.
There could be a lot of strength in knowing your identities, but it could also start to feel like a burden. I'm not representing, you know, everyone who's non-binary or genderqueer or, you know, a first generation or child of immigrants, but I know that these identities for myself influence my perspectives and that when I do have a good idea, like, it's because of all of these different perspectives. You just have to do what you need to do to be successful. And if it's asking a question or if it's admitting that, oh, this experiment went wrong because, you know, I didn't do XYZ, that's okay. through that honest, authentic representation of yourself, hopefully that will change how other people around may see those different identities that you hold. You even just being in the space is powerful.
Find people to help decode all of this, people who've been through it before, people who will tell you, like any, almost any scientist I've ever known, yes, I feel like an imposter still.
It's reassuring and very empowering for someone that says, oh, okay, well, the feelings I'm having are normal feelings, and they don't mean that I don't belong, or they don't mean that I shouldn't pursue a career in science, or they don't mean that I'm not going to be successful.
I've had several mentors in my career. One of them, when I started a job in which I was going to be running undergraduate research programs as part of that job, and I'd never done that before, I wasn't sure that I was really going to be cut out for it. And I'll never forget, she said to me that, you will be an expert in undergraduate research. And she had no doubt about it. She had such confidence. And her just saying that one thing made me realize that, oh, okay, yeah, I can do this. And was really motivating. I was like, all right, I'm ready to learn. Let's go. Mentors can really make a difference.